As the focus on vehicle emissions is becoming more and more important, nowhere has this become more of an issue for modified vehicles than in the US market. Here it's becoming increasingly difficult to legally modify your vehicle. Now, while obviously making some dramatic changes to the mechanical configuration of your engine may eliminate any chance of ever having that engine emissions compliant, what we're seeing is a lot of customers and even workshops around the world are illegally modifying vehicles and removing existing emissions compliant devices in order to supposedly improve power. Now, in some cases, some of the emissions devices, such as catalytic converters, or if you're in the diesel market, diesel particulate filters in the exhaust, can provide some restriction. Often on more modern vehicles, this actually isn't the case. And on late model vehicles, we actually find that some of these emissions devices provide essentially no restriction, and removing them will make the vehicle illegal, but actually provide no advantage in terms of engine performance. So if you are modifying a late model vehicle and you want to make sure that it does remain emissions compliant, it's really important to make sure that whoever's doing the tuning changes or modifications to the vehicle does retain these emissions devices and that they're not disabled inside of the software used for making tuning changes. Of course, in some instances, you may be pushing a vehicle to a point where those factory emissions devices do start providing some restriction. And here we've got one of the devices from Bullydog, which is an aftermarket DPF or diesel particulate filter. Now, this is designed to go in the exhaust system. It replaces an existing factory DPF, making sure that the engine and vehicle remain emissions compliant. But what it does is it improves the exhaust flow. It reduces the restriction, and in this case, the Bullydog DPF increases flow by around 20%. Another aspect of this as well, even if you aren't looking for an increase in exhaust flow, the factory DPFs can actually be quite expensive to replace, and over time they can clog up, particularly if you're not able to run them through a regen cycle frequently. And replacing these DPFs with a factory or OE component can be prohibitively expensive. In this case, the Bullydog DPF represents a cost-effective replacement product that's also going to give you that increase in exhaust flow. Since I've just mentioned the regen process, it's worth diving into this in a little bit more detail. This is actually a process that the factory ECU will go through. So when certain conditions are met, typically under the conditions where the engine is running under freeway cruising conditions, then the ECU will change the fueling parameters in order to increase the temperature in the DPF, and this burns off any residual soot that is collected in the DPF. In some instances though, the vehicle will not be driven in a manner that allows that factory regen cycle to be completed. In this instance, there are options though, and aftermarket controllers from the likes of Bullydog and SCT can be used to manually do a regen cycle. And again, this just reduces your maintenance costs and extends the life of the factory or aftermarket diesel particulate filter.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.